Hey everybody, it's Marsh Mark here, and this is my Captain America Civil War end credit scenes explained. I know, it's been like almost a month since the movie's been out, I know. But I wanted to make this video because I explained in my review that I was going to make it because I didn't put it in my review. Like, I didn't talk about the end credit scenes in my review. It was a spoiler review, but I didn't want to like add on to that. I wanted to do a separate video. And I never did it. And it's better late than never, right? Because I wanted to do it because I didn't talk about the end credit scenes at all. And I wanted to do it and cover it on my channel, so why not? So I'm wearing my Marvel shirt. I got this because tonight I'm seeing X-Men Apocalypse and I'm super excited. So before, because I heard that there's end credit scenes in that movie, before I get onto that movie doing their end credit scenes, I want to explain this movie and its end credit scenes because I really do like their end credit scenes. Also, I'm in a new background. Usually I'm filming over there, but you guys know that I've moved and I'm trying out different angles in this room because there's like a bunch of posters and I don't know if you want to see the posters. I will be doing a room tour as soon as I get it ready. I'm just not ready to do a room tour yet. I actually live streamed over an hour on my Sims channel. Go check it out. We did Alien Swarm. Caden was there too. We did Alien Swarm, some Mario minigame, another minigame like Gunblood or whatever. I don't know. Just go check out the live stream. It's really cool. There's a link down below. But other than all those updates, let's get to this video and let's explain what happened in Captain America Civil War at the end credit scenes. So in the end credit scenes, the first one, and actually do not leave because there are two end credit scenes. I don't know if any of you out there that are watching this have not seen the movie yet. It's been out for so long, and if you haven't, what the heck are you waiting for? But my friend Caden, he has not seen the movie yet. I told him everything that happened though, because he said he was just going to watch it on Blu-ray anyway. He said it wasn't that big of a deal. So he hasn't actually seen the movie yet. So there are people that haven't seen it yet. I mean, it's just true. It's just out there. So what you know, I'm saying to you guys is that if you haven't or if you know someone who hasn't seen it yet, tell them to stay over the final credits, not just the first credits, all of it. Like, just make sure they do all of the end credit scenes, because if they don't, they're going to be sorry because there's a lot of awesome stuff in both. But one of them is funny, one of them is like a funny end credit scene, one of them is a more serious, like, story-wise end credit scene. But a guy that was sitting behind me, and I actually knew this guy because he was the father of my two friends that I haven't seen in like 3 million years, but I finally saw them again at the movie, and we were at the Thursday premiere at my other town, my old town that I lived in, and so we were watching it, and he got up and after the first end credit scene, because people were leaving before the first end credit scene, guys, and then the guy and him behind me, he said, I don't know why these people leave after, you know, or I don't know why these people leave before the end credit scene of a Marvel movie. Don't they know in a Marvel movie you're supposed to say to the end of the credits? So they left, right? They left the movie after the first end credit scene. That's a no-no. He didn't take his own advice. You have to stay for all the credits because there's two end credit scenes. Marvel is like, they're probably going to be doing three next. I don't know what credit they'll put after that, like special credits, like some kind of like, this guy did this and hit on set or whatever. I don't know. Who knows? They're probably going to make up some other credit scene just to have two, or like put one after the other credit scene. I don't know, who knows, but they're gonna have like three end credit scenes, guys. I'm telling you, they're like someday in a Marvel movie, whether it's like Infinity War, whatever that's gonna be named, they're retitling it, but Infinity War, whether it is whatever, they're gonna have three. I know it is, like, I don't know, I know it is. But in the first end credit scenes, let's explain it, let's break it down. In the first end credit scene, it's Bucky, Cap, and Black Panther, and they're in this really high-tech advanced lab, and then Bucky says, yes, I'm going back into this hibernation, I'm going back to in freezing, so that I can't hurt anybody else with this stuff inside of me. Until this is out of my head, I'm staying in this cooler, this awesome freezer that they have had. And it's in this high-tech advanced lab, Cap walks over to Black Panther and says, you know they're gonna try to come for him, and then Black Panther's like, let them try. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And then it pulls out of the window and there's mist and there's a jungle and it is Wakanda, guys. Wakanda is there. You see the Black Panther statue. It's awesome. So what does this mean? I definitely think that this is speculation. I definitely think that Black Panther is going to fund the Avengers. Everybody's pretty much on the internet that I've seen has said that. I think that he's going to fund the Avengers and then give them money. Kind of like Tony Stark. He funded the Avengers for a long time. I think that since T'Challa is richer than Tony Stark, I mean, he has his own country, Tony does not, and vibranium is so valuable in the Marvel Cinematic Universe and the Marvel comic book universe, but anyway, since he's really rich, I think he's going to be funding the Avengers, and that they're going to be living in Wakanda. Like, they're wanted everywhere, guys, so I definitely think they'll be hiding out in Wakanda, and then that will be their base of operations. So I think that that's what's going on with there, and that it will lead into something in the Black Panther movie. Now, plot twist. I definitely think that Bucky will return before Infinity War because he's confirmed for that movie. But I think that he will be in Black Panther. I think that he could be in the Black Panther solo movie. Or you know, I don't know about that because they'd have to pay Sebastian Stan. But I definitely think that, that he will be Easter egged and mentioned or referenced. Or maybe they'll even see the capital he's in and they can make like a fake Sebastian Stan. Kind of like what Batman v Superman did with Zod. That was not actually Michael Shannon's body. Or at least not all of it. Because there was a dummy that had like his facial features, I think. So I definitely think that they could do that for Sebastian Stan so that they could put him in Black Panther, the solo movie. Who knows? Maybe they will, maybe they won't. I have no idea. But it is possible. And I definitely think that if not him being in the movie or having a dummy, I definitely think that they will mention him or Easter egg him in some way, right? I just think that that's what's going to go on. But what do you guys think about that? Now, second end credit scene. This is a Peter Parker end credit scene. I do like this end credit scene quite a bit. So in this one, it's really just all comical. There's not really any big serious thing there. But he is talking to Aunt May and he's like, oh my gosh, I got beat up by Steve from Brooklyn. And I was just like, oh, it's so funny. And then he says, you should have seen his friend. He was huge, like huge. Oh, that's so great. I love that end credit scene because it made me laugh. I loved it. It was great. I think that Tom Holland is Spider-Man. I love Tom Holland's Spider-Man. I'm obsessed with Tom Holland. I need to meet this kid. Oh, well, not kid because he's older than me. I need to meet this guy. I need to say how great his Peter Parker is because I'm obsessed. I want to see Spider-Man Homecoming so badly. I just want to. It's weird, but I want to see Homecoming right now because I'm addicted to Tom Holland's Spider-Man. I saw the movie twice. I saw Civil War twice, and I was so excited when Peter popped up on the screen. I was just like, oh my gosh, Tom Holland, you're perfect in every way. So I'm really excited to see where Peter Parker goes from there. But I love that Aunt May scene. It was great. But that's the two end credit scenes. I just explained them to you guys. What do you think about both of them? And do you think that Black Panther will be funding and letting the Avengers hide out in Wakanda? What do you guys think about that? And then did you guys like the Spider-Man scene? Or are you obsessed with Tom Holland like I am? Do you want to see more Spider-Man now? Comment down below. Links up to my other bonus videos. Links down there to my Twitter, Instagram, Vine, vlog channel, and Sim channel. Don't forget to like and favorite this video. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys later. Bye-bye.